All right, well, yesterday and the day before, after I got my head out of my ass, I was able to mill out, I think it's 2 1/4 inch thick stock out of that reclaimed treated. Ran them through the joiner, squared them up, got everything as accurate as I could get it with what I'm dealing with, and made a dry fit. So that, I think I told you, yeah, that octagon will be eventually be this piece that says 23 5/8. So what I'm planning on doing, I haven't quite made my mind up. I'm either gonna biscuit joint just for added strength, or I'm gonna take a slot cutter, the same slot cutter that messed my hand up. I'll take a slot cutter and groove the length of this joint and then put a spline in there, which would probably be better. Anyway, I'm still vacillating on that as to what to do. So I got that one, and I've got this one dry fitted. I'm gonna figure out what the hell I'm doing and then try and glue those up. And then I was able to mill out these square bases, 4 inches thick by 25. I mean, I had a hell of a time yesterday. But I milled these out. I'm getting ready to cut the miters on them, and I've got the same dilemma, you know, biscuit joints or splines or, you know, however I'm going to fasten the miters together. But I was pulling nails. See, I missed one right there. And, you know, my joiner, anyway, my joiner knives are dull as shit, which makes it really difficult and miserable and unpleasant. It would go a lot quicker if I had sharp knives, which I got knives on order. They're supposed to come tomorrow, and it's going to take me 4 hours to switch these things out probably, because it's a pain in the ass. But, you know, there is a method, and it's easier. Well, one, it's easier to use clean, fresh stock, which I don't have. You know, you don't have to worry about pulling nails and chipping your saw blades or your knives or whatever. But this is good material. It's been dried forever and a day. It'll be stable. It's treated. It's in a wet condition. So this is the right choice, as miserable as it may make me during work. I mean, I could easily go get, you know, fir or yellow pine or something, but, you know, if they don't, and they're all rental properties, so they don't keep the property up, so they're going to rot out again. So I figured I may as well just bite the bullet and go with treated. You know, believe it or not, I mean, that looks like shit, but this is the wood that's inside of it. You just got to get to it. So hopefully today, if I can maintain my attitude, my health, and don't run into any more mechanical failures, I should have those octagon pedestals glued up, and hopefully these square bases glued up. And if I'm really, really fortunate and lucky, I'll start milling out the most challenging part of this whole project is that piece right there. Because It's one piece, but I gotta make it in two pieces because I don't have that knife or that bit. I can't run it through at one pass. So what I gotta do is make it in two pieces. Cut the radiuses out. Reference it with some dowel rods or something. Then separate them and wrap the top knife part and the bottom knife part. Then sandwich it back together and glue it together as one. You talk about a pain in the ass. I did it last week and it was not fun. Hopefully I learned something from my experience last week, but we'll see. I'll make you some more videos as I get it done. All right, see ya.